in order to...
Then you talked about the distinctive headgear that they wear, the fez, and which we've seen all these at circuses, at parades. They come down the street on their motorcycles wearing their fez. Tell us, first of all, what is the Shriners, and what is the significance of that fez?
Well, you'll see the men in the Shrine parades and the Shrine circus wearing their red fez. In order to be a Shriner, you have to reach the highest degrees of Freemasonry, either the 32nd degree of the Scottish Rite or 13th degree of the York Rite. And then you're allowed to go into the shrine. And sadly, many Christians have gone into this, which is hard to understand, because in order to be a Shriner, in the initiation, every Shriner takes a blood oath of allegiance to Allah as his God and Muhammad as his prophet.
Now, are you kidding me?
No. But you swear allegiance that Allah is your God, Muhammad is your prophet. You are then given this red fez with the Islamic sword and crescent, encrusted in jewels on the front of it. And you'll see men wearing this. And people say, well, why do they wear the red fez? It is because if you study history, during the 7th and 8th century, as the Muslims swept across North Africa, they came to Fez, Morocco. And in Fez, Morocco, there was a large community of Christians. And Muhammad had ordered the slaughter of all the infidels, meaning Christians, who would not bow down to Allah and Muhammad as the prophet. And the Muslims went in with the Islamic sword, and there in Fez slaughtered thousands of Christians. And then they took their Fez hats, and they dipped it in the blood of Christians, glorying in the defeat of Christianity. And that's why the Fezes are red, representing the blood of Christians defeated by the Islamic sword, which they have encrusted in jewels on the front. And there are Christians who walk around wearing this hat, and Dave, to be honest, it's an abomination in the eyes of God.